here. How are you guys? I hope you guys are good. And before I start with this video, I am gonna remind you, of course, to hit that bell. Subscribe to my channel because a lot of new videos is coming and you don't want to miss those. You don't want to. So hit that button and subscribe to my channel. And like and comment my videos, share my videos and everything. That means a lot for me. A lot, you guys. So now, I am gonna start with the main thing with this video. Which is, I know a lot of like goth YouTubers have did that before. And now I think it's my turn. I don't know if that's still like, I don't know, most of you to did like a couple of years ago, but I guess it's my turn now, which is the 10 on goth confessions. So I am gonna start with my first on goth confession, which is also, I think, like the biggest one. And that's the one I like. The sun. I love being in the sun. I love when it's warm and I just love being in the sun. And if I, that's one of the reasons why I moved to LA, of course, because I love the sun. It's one of the sunniest cities in the world. So, and I wake up and in the morning and I know it's sunny. I am gonna be so much more happier than in a rainy day. So I guess that's the first on goth confession, because I think when you're goth you're supposed to like more cloudy weather and more rain, but that's not me. I always gonna prefer sunny and sun with sun, the sun before any other weather, always, always. So then let's move on to the on goth confession number 2, which is connected to number 1. Summer is my favorite time of the year. Yes, it is. Of course, I like the sun. So obvious, the summer should be my favorite time of the year. And that's also why I moved to Los Angeles, because here is summer all year round and I can be happy. I used to have a struggle from a lot of depression in the winter because not enough sunlight, not enough like warm weather. So of course, I love the summer and everything you can do in the summer, of course, the festivals and everything that's like the best with the summer. And let's move on to the ungoth confession number 3. And I think some like goth YouTubers have that confession too, and I think that applies to me too, which is I don't like black coffee. Before, I didn't drink coffee at all. I hated everything that was the coffee taste. Right now, since I got older, I kind of like the coffee taste, but I don't like black coffee. I only drink like coffee drinks, like chai latte, and I also drink my favorite one, which is caramel frappe, which is coffee, but it's like coffee drinks. So that's, I would say I'm drinking with coffee, but regular black coffee is big. No, no, I hate that. That's disgusting. So no, no, no on that one. And with that, we're gonna move on to confession number 4, which is I have never smoked a cigarette. I hate cigarettes. I hate the cigarette smoke, and I don't feel like, why do I have to try out doing that? So I never ever try a cigarette in my life, and I'm not gonna do that either. Because I don't feel like, why? Why? I don't wanna have like yellow skin and, you know, get all those when you smoke. No, 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 no. That's no. I don't do that. I mean, I don't have any problem with people really smoke around me, but I will never try that cigarette. That's like, no. So that's one. And then we move on to confession number 5. And this one, I have to say, is really like a confession for me, because I think most of people think I don't have that confession, but I have that. And that is, I don't like vegetables. I don't really eat vegetables at all. And I know that's not good at all. I know vegetables is healthy, but technically I don't eat any green things beside of avocado. Avocado is like the only like kind of vegetables I eat. But because I know like in the goth culture it's where like a lot of like vegetarians and vegans, and I have no problem with that, but I would never able to eat that and go into that lifestyle, because I can't eat vegetables. I mean, I have tried to eat that, but it's like, and taste it, but no, it's just, I feel like my body just wanna react it. And I don't know if it's like the green color or something, because I had even problem with eat like green pasta just because it's the color green. So that's kind of weird thing I have. And I know that's not good for me, but right now I'm healthy, so I hope I'm continue staying healthy even if I don't eat greens and vegetables. And then we can move on to confession number 6. And that's one thing. Victoria's Secret is actually my favorite perfume. I love Victoria's Secret perfume. And my favorite one is the one that's called Tease. And I love the bottle, and it's so pretty, and I love the taste, and it's the smell, and not taste, of course I'm not eating it, but I love the smell, and it's so lovely. So Victoria Lovelace perfume, but no, the Victoria's Secret one, all those perfumes, I had tried a lot of them, and they are just lovely. And I don't know if I really like those typical gothic perfumes. I think they are like too strong. I love sweet ones. That's my kind of perfume. So that one is like a little bit crazy, but yeah, that was confession number 6. And after that we move on to confession number 7. And with that one, it's like, yeah, that comes to like the music. And I listen to a lot of different kind of music, and then one of my actually favorite genre is 80s music. 80s pop music, actually, like mainstream music. I love like Madonna and like Michael Jackson, all those like they consider were like mainstream. And that's, I'm probably listening to that like every day. And that's like 80s music, pop music is gonna probably go over like everything else for me, because it's like, I don't know, I'm like grown up with that music. And because I mean, I so wish I was able to be like a teenager or like in the 80s. I always loved the 80s, everything with the aesthetic, but especially the music. That's like, I just love the 80s. It is just feels very happy, like a happy era. So I wish, I mean, I'm born like in the 80s, but I don't remember anything, unfortunately. So yeah, and now move on to confession number 8, which is my favorite color. And surprise surprise, my favorite colors is not black, which it should be. I'm goth, I should have, my favorite color should be black, but it's actually not. I would say like in clothes I mostly like wear black, but if it comes to like a color to like look at, just a color I feel like very like satisfying with, which I became like happy with, is actually the color magenta. And for you guys that don't know about, never heard of, what color is that? I never heard about that color. It's actually like a color that's little bit like mixed like red, pink with a little like purple. So it's like technically like a color that's mixed between red and purple, I will say, with that one. And that has always been my favorite color my whole life since I was a kid, and it still is. So with that, let's move on to confession number 9, which is, yeah, it's kind of crazy. I had never read any book of the biggest gothic authors, which is considered, usually people used to consider Edgar Allan Poe or Lovecraft. I don't know anything about those authors. I had never ever read a story. I had never ever read a book from them. I don't really know anything that they, other than they are supposed to be, they are the biggest like gothic literature influencer, but I don't know anything about them. Never read anything, so I just don't know. Maybe I will try to read something, I don't know, in the future, but I don't know. So with that, let's move on to confession number 10 and the last confession. And I think with that one, I think I have already kind of talked with about that one in the video, the goth tag, because it asked me how I got into this goth subculture. And I don't know if that's really considered like a goth confession, but yeah, technically, because usually people say you are supposed to start with the goth subculture and get influenced by the music and then to the fashion. But for me it was the opposite, actually. I started with the fashion before I discovered the music. So I didn't know anything about any gothic bands or anything before I started with the fashion. And then when I started to have more friends within the gothic scene, and then I got influenced to the music through that, which is usually goes like the opposite way. So that's my 10 on goth confessions, and I hope you guys like the video, and also that give you a little bit more like information about me, and get you guys start to know me more and everything. And you can also watch my goth tag video, which also a little bit like you get to know me a little bit better too. And I have to say, Faye, again, thank you so much for watching this video. And if you like the video, give it a thumbs up and also hit the bell button to get notification. As I was saying again, a lot of more videos is coming. So, thank you so much. Bye.